This is a series on home automation basics. I'll be covering some of the essentials like modes and scenes, automations, geofencing, voice assistants, and how to secure your smart home devices. In the last video, I walk through scenes and how to set them up. If you haven't seen that one yet, I'll include a link in the description, or you can jump back one video in the home automation basics playlist. In this video, I'll be jumping into routines and modes, which is where smart homes really start to get fun. While I will be giving examples from different systems like SmartThings, Google, Amazon, and others, this is meant to be a platform-agnostic view on home automation. These are core concepts and they apply no matter what system you're using. If you're just getting started, then this is the series to watch. If you're already building out your smart home, this still may spark some ideas. But before we dive in, take a moment and hit that subscribe button so you don't miss out on the full series of these videos. I'm Matt Ferrell. Welcome to Undecided. Routines, routines, routines. This is where I really started to get hooked on smart homes because routines can pull together a wide grouping of random devices and trigger them all at the same time. It's routines that act as the glue between everything in your home and put a lot of power at your fingertips. The most common pre-configured routines you'll often use in some of the apps are things like good morning, good night, I'm leaving, I'm back, and vacation. And those preset routines will usually cover 90% of what you need. But as you use your system more, you'll start to have epiphanies for fun and creative routines to add in there too. Watch a movie, play a game, have a party. But don't go nuts first. Start with the basics and grow from there as needs arise. So let's follow that premise and start simple and work on a good morning routine. In SmartThings, you can tap on the automation navigation and then make sure that the routines tab is selected at the top. Same thing for Apple Home. Tap on the automation navigation and you're right where you need to be. In Amazon Alexa, tap on the hamburger menu and then tap on routines. In Google Home, you need to tap on the routines button, then manage routines. If there's a pre-configured good morning routine, you can tap into that to edit it or just create a brand new one. To start fresh, tap the create or add button. Now, what is it we want to do? Let's say that every weekday morning I get up at 6 a.m. and want my heating and air conditioning system to kick on at 70 degrees Fahrenheit. And before the rest of the world yells at me in the comments, I know the US should be using metric, no argument for me, but we don't. So forgive the use of Fahrenheit. And let's say we want the bedroom lights to automatically turn on to a very dim level to help me as I wake up. And maybe turn on the kitchen ceiling lights to help me as I stumble my way into the kitchen for a cup of hot tea. Oh, and maybe start playing my local news on the smart speakers in the bedroom and the kitchen for the systems that support that. In Apple Home, it's easy to set up the lights by tapping Create a New Automation, and then a time of day occurs. Set the time to 6 a.m. Turn off Saturday and Sunday because nobody wants to wake up early if they don't have to, and select When I am home. This ensures that the system doesn't trigger this while you're traveling or not home. On the next screen, you can select individual lights or a scene. Let's select the scene that we created in the last video. Also select your thermostat, which for me is the Ecobee. If you tap and hold on the thermostat, you'll get the controls to configure the temperature the way you want it. Save that out. If you're using Amazon, you tap on When This Happens, then Schedule, then At Time. Set it to repeat on weekdays. After hitting Next, you'll tap on Add Action, tap on Smart Home, then Control Scene, and find the scene that you created for the bedroom. You can also add another device to control and select your thermostat, and then set the temperature. You can also add Play News to your automation here to start playing your flash briefing. And as you probably imagine, SmartThings is very similar. You can link your bedroom scene that you created, set your thermostat, and your temperature. And for Google Home, it's a similar deal, but you can only schedule custom routines. You can't use the pre-configured routines for scheduling, only for voice. So tap the plus button, tap Set a Time and Day, and configure this to the time that you want. Tap the back button and then add action, then popular actions. On here, you'll want to check adjust scenes and adjust thermostat. Be sure to also tap the gear icon next to each item to add specific scenes or devices to control. Back up to the new routine start screen again and tap add action and type in play news. This will automatically play your news briefing if you have one configured in Google Home. You'll also need to set a voice command for this feature, even if you don't end up using it. While each of these systems have very different user interfaces and sometimes slightly different terminology, the basics are all the same. You can create a routine to trigger at a specific time, specific day, only when you're home or when you're away. Or you could create routines that are triggered manually by you through the app or with a voice command through Google, Amazon, or Siri. So for the good morning example that we just ran through, you could use your voice trigger command instead of a set time. Then when you wake up in the morning, all you have to say is, "Hey, what's your name? Good morning." And everything you put into the routine starts up. But I'll be diving more into the details on voice assistants in a future video, so stay tuned for that. In the next video, we'll be diving into geofencing, which is all about triggering routines based on where you are. This is where the smart in smart home really starts to kick in. Drop any questions you have in the comments and let me know what kind of scenes and routines you have set up and get the most use out of. If you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends because it really helps the channel. And if you'd like to support the channel, there's some more ways that you can do so. Check out my SFSF shop for some cool Tesla, SpaceX, science, and Undecided t-shirts. There are other links in the description for some great Tesla accessories and discounts. And an extra big thank you to my Patreon supporters. Your help is making all these videos possible. And if you're interested in early access to videos, behind the scenes posts, check out my Patreon page for additional details. If you haven't already, consider subscribing and hitting that notification bell to get alerts when I post new videos. And as always, thanks so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one.